About 6 a.m. I just left the parking lot, hoping to start skiing by 10. And by my calculations, it should be, yeah, hopefully less than 4 hours to the top. I've got quite a ways up there.
So some of the best ways to find ski lines when you go to a new place that you don't know, if you can look for a guidebook, that's the easiest way. Drive around, see what you see from the road. I've skied quite a few that I've just kind of found from driving up random roads, and looks like fun, so we go ski it. I like to use Google Earth, and you can basically search all over. You can find hidden trails, whether they're marked on maps or not, for either getting up or getting out. So today, before I got here, I looked on Google Earth, kind of found out where the snow was holding, some of the other couloirs, the best way either to like go on one side of the lake or the other. As I was able to walk up to the ridge, I noticed on there that if you came around the back of the ridge, it wasn't too steep, make it all the way to the summit from there, and then ski the couloir. Normally without looking on there, you wouldn't be able to tell from here. It kind of looks like a really big cliff on this side, and you wouldn't want to risk getting up there and it being a cliff on the backside. So by checking out Google Earth, you can see, walk right up there, mellow on the back, hike right to the summit. And this is safer for one reason. You don't have to hike up the couloir that you're gonna ski, which in the springtime, you have a lot of issues with debris coming down. You have rocks, you have wet slides. So if you're in the couloir for 3 hours, you are much more likely to get injured.
Made it to the top in just over 3 hours. It's about 4,100 vert, so that's pretty good. Got up here right about when I thought, before 10 o'clock, and the snow softened up pretty nicely. Worked out pretty perfect. The track I saw on Google Earth, was able to walk by the lake and then just cruise up to the ridge. And now I know exactly where the route is because I saw the first couloir is the Mendenhall, and the second one is the one I'm going for, called the Pinner. So I'm gonna ski over there, see how it's softening up. Tossed a couple rocks and they all stuck in, so don't have to worry about ice on the upper part at least. Best to do the scariest part, which is this upper face. If it gets too warm, then you risk wet sliding. So I'm gonna ski this, get it out of the way, and then yeah, hopefully it's soft corn and I can just ski it all the way through.
All right, here it goes. Yeah, that's why you don't want to be here too late. All of these cliffs up here could have wet slides coming down. So I want to get out of here. Oh yeah, that was pretty fun.
It actually turned out perfect. It was soft at the top, great corn skiing into the couloir, and then it was nice and soft the whole way down. Definitely not the smoothest snow. A lot of debris has been through there, and a lot of just big chunks. It's important to ski it before it gets too soft, especially coming out this lower apron. When it gets isothermic, you just fall through and you can easily just like injure your arms or your knees or your face on a rock. So good idea to get in and out while it's soft, and I think I timed it perfect. Try to take a shortcut and ski as far down as I could to the lake and then find the summer trail, but ended up just in nasty bushes and having to cross the creek. So probably wasn't a shortcut, but eventually made it back to this trail, so it wasn't too bad. And now I got about a mile, maybe a mile and a half back to the car. But it's a pretty successful day. And I just have to jump in the lake.
Came down, jumped in the lake, and had some lunch and heading back to town. So thanks for watching, and don't forget to subscribe for more videos throughout the spring and next winter. So, all right, I'll see you later.